Hey guys, good afternoon. It's your girl T once again on your favorite channel, Wake Up and Embrace Self. So guys, in the last video, we looked at why we should have multiple streams of income, five major reasons why we should have multiple streams of income, right there to pursue your passion, to retire early, to be able to do other things and so on and so forth. And I remember promising you guys that in the next video, we're going to talk about how we can actually generate multiple streams of income. So here we go. I want to tag this, how to generate multiple streams of income. Stay tuned, guys. Streams of income is actually a financial dream that a lot of us have nurtured for a very long time. But the sad part of it is that our educational system do not teach us anything about entrepreneurship or money management. So we practically have to learn everything on our own. From the kind of business that you can start, to raising capitals, to execution and all that goes with it, you basically and practically have to learn everything on your own. It is also very sad that a lot of Africans do not understand money and capital markets, so they have no business with multiplying their money. They do not even multiply their money at all. So they only work for the money and not the other way around. Instead of the money working for them, they work for the money. Now, when thinking of generating multiple streams of income, there are five major rules that should come to your mind at all times. And here they are. Rule number one, get financial education and understand the basics. I bet you do not want to start any business when you have no idea about money management, capital markets, and all that it entails. So you need to, first of all, get that financial education and understand everything that has to do with business. Rule number two, don't just work for the money. Let the money work for you. It's going to be a very sad thing if all you do is wake up in the morning, go to work, and you come back at the end of the month, you get your salary. You're working for the money. By the time you start investing and doing other stuff that comes with financial management, the money will start working for you. Rule number three, you have to build an emergency fund. What's this emergency fund? Savings. How do you save? I'm sure you need to figure out how to save. Saving is one key factor if you really, really have to generate multiple streams of income, because that's where most of your capital would actually come from. So you need to start building an emergency fund for yourself. Rule number four, build a business. After doing this, then you can actually sit down and start building your own business. And the last rule is you need to learn to work with partners. Having different partners that work with you would actually help skyrocket your business very fast, because you already have different people working together, different people sharing ideas on how to move the business forward. Most times you cannot do things on your own, so you really, really need to learn to work with partners. Okay, so having known these rules that you should have in mind when thinking of starting other streams of income, let's move ahead to how can you actually start. You know, a lot of people really, really want to start owning different kind of businesses, but there's always this fear from the inception, at the initial stage, like, how do I go about this, what do I do, what if I fail, you know, different questions coming into your head and all that. And like I mentioned in the last video, entrepreneurs take risk, so it's one risk that you're ready to take. Now, how do we actually go about this? The first step here is you need to actually create a mind map of the kind of business that you would love to do. You need to get a sheet of paper and write it down. What kind of business do I have to do? Put it up in a circle and write the kind of business. Then you can go ahead to draw up different lines around it. That's different spokes connecting to your big question. What kind of business do I start? Those spokes around it would actually give you the category of business you want to do. Then how do you intend to make money from this business? Various ways that you can actually make this money, or various other sources of income that you can actually get, include books. It's either you're writing a book or you're selling books. You know, people love to read, and I think books is one major business that moves even in Nigeria and other countries. So you can either write a book, something meaningful, something that can actually wow your audience, or you can pick up very good fascinating books and decide to sell, and you see yourself making huge money from it. Apart from books, there are other earning sources that includes online coaching, freelancing, public speaking, training, merchandise, that's the act of buying and selling, training, advertising,
and even affiliate marketing, and so many others. All these earning sources should be able to develop extra income streams for you one way or the other. So you just need to sit down and, you know, create a mind map, like I said earlier, on how you, the kind of business you want to do, how to go about it, what are the marketing strategies that you need to involve in the business, and how do you want to make money from it. So the second thing I would like to let you know is you need to focus more on passive income. When I say passive income, I'm talking about something that you do once and it keeps making money for you over and over again. For example, book writing is a passive income. You write the book once, but it keeps selling again and again. There are so many other forms of passive income that includes audio or video creation, franchising, affiliate marketing, and so many others. Unlike non-passive income, where you have to do the service again and again before you make the money. For example, if I have to train a group of people, for me to train the set, I need to do that service once, get the money, do the service again and again. So passive income is just a goal. You need to think of something that you can just do once, and even while you sleep, it keeps creating money for you. Another thing is to focus on an income stream that can expand your business. For example, public speaking or even teaching. These are stuffs that you can actually do alongside and they make money for you. Even freelance writing, in which you get paid for an article that you write that would promote you and also promote your business. Guys, I have just explained how you can actually generate different streams of income for yourself. But here, there are some things that I want you to note. The first one is choose and set up one income stream at a time. Avoid the temptation of having so many streams of income, because by the time you start putting all your ideas together, you might be tempted to want to do 3, 4, 5, or 6 of them at the same time. And putting your focus into so many areas at once will definitely dilute your effort and it will slow you down. So please choose one income stream at a time. When you've built that one so strong and it can actually start working for you, you can try something else like that. That is how you build different streams of income and not having all of them at the same time. The second thing I want you to note here is that work to have systems, schedules, and tools that can help you manage that stream of income, that one that you have started. You need to learn to be organized, you understand? Have a system, have a schedule, have different tools that can help you manage the existing income stream that you have before creating another. And finally, if your new stream of income is not generating any income for you, or you do not like it, you hate it, please, I beg, drop it. That's the simple truth, because if you keep striving to do that same business when you do not like it, you're not going to put in your best into it, and you're definitely going to get frustrated at the end. Trust me. Let me quickly add this to it. Remember that money does not just drop from heaven for you to start your business. There are some kind of businesses that are capital intensive, and so for those kind of business, you really need a huge capital to start. So what do? You have your primary salary that you can save from, which might not actually be enough for you, so you can decide to want to get a loan from a microfinance or anywhere just to start your business. A lot of these banks and other microfinances do not give startup capitals, but they are various ways that you can actually earn small money to start up with something small. Start up with something small first. Do not just sit down and start waiting for that 1 million naira or 500,000 that you need to start up that big business. What's that small thing that you can start with today that can actually generate something for you that you can use into starting up that big business that you have in mind? For those of you that are tech savvy, why not make use of the internet? There are a lot of things that you can, there are a lot of opportunities and businesses that you can do online that involves websites and design, graphics design, so many other stuff like that. So why not make use of what you already have and harness it? Use it to make a little money, save up from what you have, and then move over to starting up that big business that you have in mind. So guys, I am rounding up with this episode on how to make how to generate multiple streams of income, and I want to leave you with these 5 points. My 5 closing remarks are: 1, learn about finance. Do not forget to have a financial education before starting up anything. Secondly, you need to start a small business by the side. 3, remember to grow your business. It's one thing to start a business, it's another thing to grow that business. The 4th thing you need to do is learn to invest. Invest, reinvest, in fact, invest like crazy. And the fifth and the most interesting part of it is you can retire. So guys, this is me signing out today. I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope to see you again in the next episode of Wake Up and Brace Up. Please stay tuned, and if you are yet to subscribe, please do so immediately, like right now. Just click on the subscribe button, and if you like the video, do not forget to click on the like button. Like subscribe, and if you also have something to say, please leave a comment in the video below. I would love to read it, and let's rub minds together. Thank you so much for viewing this episode. I'll see you again in the next episode. Till then, please remain safe, like I always say, and bye guys, bye.